We're just beside ourselves, and we're just so excited that we have been chosen to be a finalist, and we want to welcome Jason and Nikki Wynn, and of course they are on their way, and they may be pulling in the parking lot very soon.
This is exciting.
You got
my heart pounding here. I'm just thrilled. Do now to make it all happen?
Well, when you see Jason and Nikki, of course, just be the way you always are. You know, people around here, they're genuine people.
Just be yourself. Be yourself.
Right. Okay. Yes.
Something like, I got tears in my ears from lying on my back in my bed while I cry over you tonight, little darling. I'm going down this road feeling bad.
Start with a walk down Main Street, where you can find people talking outside shops and music in the streets.
Ain't gonna be treated this way.
We are treated to a fabulous lunch at Trio, a local favorite where you can find upscale dining and friendly service. We get a squad car tour of the city with local tour guide Mike Cockrum and the mayor, who loves to shout out greetings at the locals on the street.
What are y'all doing?
Giving the folks from New York a tour.
That's great.
Nikki and Jason.
Just got out.
Hi, Otis.
That's our logo, Otis, in person.
We stopped by Floyd's to run in and say hello to one of the oldest barbers in town. He was Andy Griffith's barber.
Good to see y'all.
And he takes a photo of everyone who gets a haircut in his shop, because to him, they're all friends.
Still Mount Airy, but Mayberry has really made it special. People here, well, you won't go anywhere without you'll find any more friendlier people than there are in this area.
Absolutely. You've been cutting hair for how long?
It's almost 65 years, and the friendship that I've had all these years worth more than anything.
I'm having fun too.
Just going to be on TV.
I saw the need to come back home to Mount Airy, and I'd have walked up or crawled up 77, Interstate 77, to get back to good old Mount Airy.
We run next door to one of Andy Griffith's favorites, Snappy Lunch, where you can get a mean pork chop sandwich and a little taste of Mayberry.
Come back.
Next up is the largest open-faced quarry in the world. It's so big and sparkly from all the mica that it can be seen from outer space. Even the aliens know where Mount Airy is on the globe. We pass by the local park where the city donated the land and the people raised the funds to have it built. We're feeling the community love.
Oh, look here!
Marty!
We make a quick stop off at Olympia Family Cafe for a glass of sweet tea and a chit-chat with some locals.
Mount Airy is the friendliest on the road.
Very nice.
Driving down Main Street, you get a good feel for the town's history and start to see where the idea for Mayberry came about. We make a stop by Andy's home place. You can make a reservation to stay in the home, where most of the furniture still exists, as it did when Andy was growing up. We throw on the lights and rush to the park, where we're greeted by a friendly puppy and meet up with George Snappenfield, the creator of disc golf. We jump right into playing a few holes where we can get a few pointers, and we learn the history of the game. Now that's what you call straight from the horse's mouth. George was so kind, he even autographed a disc for us. We wave to some friendly fishermen and head to find ourselves at the Thailand Cafe. We meet the restaurant family and learn that we're going to be making some basil rolls.
Anybody can cook for y'all, but who's going to make your own food, you know? Okay, yeah, because what you're going
to
do?
Race against the mayor. I don't even know if I'm allowed to beat her.
Sticky. Because I got too much stuff in it. Oh, and it's...
You got a salad.
They're rolling.
little one's too fat. Ta-da!
Okay, we're going to get everybody in judge. Yours is pretty, man.
After all the work and excitement, we sit down to a family-style vegetarian cuisine.
Which is going to change the flavor of the food.
But, they use the dried chili flakes.
All right, guys, thanks for stopping by. It's been a pleasure meeting y'all. I hope y'all enjoyed everything, and my family also enjoyed you guys coming here. So yeah, have a safe trip. Bye.
We get a private tour of the Mount Airy History Museum, where we get to learn a bit more about the town's past. You can see what life was like for Native Americans and early settlers, or experience an authentic turn-of-the-century country store. You can learn about hometown heroes and listen to the old-time music that was unique to the area. And of course, you can see an exhibit of NASCAR, the official state sport. My favorite was the children's play area.
Oh, they're all puppets. Oh, see, I wish we had more time. I'd give you a show.
Mount Airy's been claiming themselves the friendliest city since the early 60s. We walk across the street to the Old North Winery, where the owners tell us how they got started, give us a tour, and we even get to experience barrel tasting.
Some winemakers don't like you doing this.
Hey, Bordeaux.
You can even catch one of the local pastors playing live music on many evenings.
Keep playing your part.
We sample a few varieties out of the bottle and then head to the amphitheater.
Mount Airy is in the running for the friendly city of America. They've narrowed it down to 6 cities. Yes, 6 cities.
There's no lack of excitement about the friendliness of this city. People of Mount Airy know how to get down. They love the amphitheater, and Thursday, Friday, and Saturday nights, you can always find a good crowd and plenty of friendly dancing partners. Watch out, ladies. Albert is at every venue, and he is a dancing machine. Danced into the wee hours of the night. Thanks for a great day, Mount Airy. We can't wait for tomorrow. The next morning, we meet up at the Greenbelt Park for a bike ride with the mayor. Along the trail, we run across a local church gathering for a baptism in the river. For the young at heart, you can do a scavenger hunt along the way and post your findings online for a prize. The trail is a quick 2.2 miles each way. After the ride, we head over to do a little shopping. They knew we were on limited time, so they were so nice to open a little early for us. Jason picks up a new pair of kicks, and we're off. We stop by for one last look at the Andy Griffith Playhouse and reflect on our trip. We truly feel like the modern-day Andy and Opie in this friendly town. Thanks for the hospitality, Mount Airy.